How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Minecraft Let's Play. My name, of course, is System Z, and I am still wearing the pirate hat. I forgot about it, but look at that. It looks great, you know? I'm a fashionable pirate, though, you've got to admit. I've got the beard for it, too. It's really cool. And a cape and diamond pants. That's why I'm fashionable. But welcome back, guys. It's been a while, and I'm sorry for that. Truth be told, the ideas have just not been flowing, and I don't want to lose inspiration on this cabin, so I didn't want to force anything. I'm just trying to wait for ideas to come around. But I've got a few, and I've expanded just a little bit, just a little sneak peek. You can see there's some stuff going on with the roof. Just, you can't really tell from here. But you know what? Let's focus on this. It's a little bit different. I've done a little bit of landscaping. As you guys know, I've been live streaming on the Twitch platform lately, and we've been doing some crazy stuff. I've been landscaping everything and just making some cool stuff happen, and I think it's turning out great. And part of this might have something to do with what we're doing this episode. I'm trying to debate on whether or not we should work on the cabin or work on the bridge today. So I'm going to decide that before we continue, but I've got a few things to show you, but before we do that, let me go ahead and say thank you to everyone who sent in the submissions for the Twitter comment question of the day, or tweet of the day, from last episode. You sent in all of your builds that you're building in your own Let's Plays, and it inspired me. I'll be honest, it inspired me. You guys are building some pretty cool stuff, so hopefully by now you've seen them on the screen. And I also want to thank Corey for submitting a door design. We're going to kind of do something like that, but not quite the same thing. But it's definitely enough to inspire me. But it's very similar to your design, so thank you. But anyways, guys, on one of my live streams, I believe it was the first one, we created this little secret cave. You can barely even see the button for it when you're walking past. But basically, as you guys know, for the longest time, I used shulker boxes for storage, which seemed like a great idea at the time. It sure did, but it was not a great idea at all. I'll admit, it was the worst idea I've had. So we created a storage room because we needed it, and we've got an anvil in here, all our basic stuff, you know, some like furnaces to cook stuff, a portal, and an enchantment room. We've got everything going for us, and we are collecting resources actively, and it's looking good. I've even got some slime balls. Isn't that great? And then some bones and one gunpowder. I've been trying to get some more fireworks, but it's been hard, but we've got a little bit, which is fine. But yeah, so that's where we're at. But let me show you guys some of the changes to the cabin I've made. And today, if we work on the cabin, we're gonna work on this part that we just flew through. But yeah, let's take a step back here. Whoop, there we go. You can see there's some windows up there now. This is totally not a good view. Let's try and maybe go on top of one of these trees here and get a better view, a little backed up. There we go, kind of. So I'm not really sure if I like it. I'll be honest, I'm not entirely sure if I like it. It's a little odd. It looks like a monster. It really does, especially because of the messy roof. But I don't know, I think it'll all come together. And even so, the thing about cabins is they're usually symmetrical. So that's kind of why I wanted to do that. But you can see I've matched this side over there ever so slightly. And we've put a tree here, which I may or may not remove. And then I was experimenting with some windows up there. I think I like them, but I don't know. So let me know what you guys think. It looks like a monster, though. It really does. But anyways, guys, I have spent enough time talking. I know you guys are ready to get on into the episode, so stay tuned for the comment question of the day. We are going to go ahead and get started. I think we're going to work on the bridge, but don't hold me to that. Anyways, guys, grab your snacks, grab your drinks, grab yourself, and grab everything else about you, and enjoy the episode. My name, of course, is System Z. If you enjoy Minecraft, make sure to subscribe so you're notified when I upload, and let's go ahead and get right on into the episode. There's nothing quite as awesome as just flying through the air. Very cool, very magical. We are using our elytra today to head over to the swampland in hopes of grabbing some lily pads. We need those right there. And I think I can get them just with my hand, but I brought some shears just in case. Let's try it. Karate chop. We did it. We got it. Perfect. Now we need a few more. A few hundred. No, we only need like 8. But I'm going to just collect a few. And we're going to talk about something. So I've been kind of reviewing the updates that have kind of been introduced to the game over the past few months, really, up to about a year, just kind of out of boredom, but just to kind of see if there was some stuff I missed. And there was some stuff I missed. One thing in particular, and it actually pertains to something we've been needing to do. So, as you guys remember, you used to need to use Silk Touch on shears in order to even get, like, cobwebs. Apparently, they took that away. So you can actually just use shears and get cobwebs. So as you guys know, we need some cobwebs. Hopefully, you know, you assume that already, considering we have a gigantic chimney that has no smoke coming out of it. We need to fix that thing and get it going and light it. That way we can feel a little bit more at home with our unfinished large cabin that's kind of okay, but still kind of ugly. That's my own opinion of it anyways. I know a lot of you like it, but I am struggling with it so bad. But anyways, that's what we're going to do for the ending of the episode, I think, is go get some cobwebs. But for now, we've got a bridge to build, so I'm going to head on back over here, and we're going to get everything going. You know, I just had some frame rate issues. I've been having a lot of those today, and I don't know what the problem is. It's on this world only, though. I've been able to record Sky Exchange. I've been able to record Pokemon. I don't know what the deal is. I hope this world isn't becoming damaged. That would be bad. But we're going to come in here into our storage room, grab our bag of building, throw the lily pads in there. Let me make sure I've got everything I need. Oak wood. Oak slabs, of course. Jungle slabs. A little bit of oak fence. Can't go wrong. Birch leaves. Always good. I think that's all we're going to need. We might want to also grab some dirt, though. It's always nice to have just some sort of scaffolding block. So let's throw that in there. Don't know why I've got this coal in here, but that's fine. That's all dandy. But yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and maybe try and plan out a little bit. That way I'm not just aimlessly placing around and wasting your time. So let me take a moment as a builder to kind of adjust to the area and figure out what we're going to do. And just like that, I had an idea. We're going to do a wooden kind of droopy bridge, and I've placed not really the framework, but just some logs there to kind of give me an idea of where it's supposed to start and end. Now, I've already built this in my testing world, so we're going to pretty much follow the design of that. But I am going to try and make it a little bit unique, but at the same time, I know this is a design that'll look good. So the commentary is probably not going to be that great here, just because I do have an image right beside me of what I'm supposed to be doing. But I did simplify it just a little bit, so it shouldn't be too bad. But guys, I just wanted to talk a minute about why I'm getting frame rate issues. I have no clue, and I'm hoping you do. I mean, like, I'm not even joking. It is getting so bad, I cannot play today. It's the weirdest thing. I'm sitting at a good 145 right now while recording, which is good, but it just randomly drops, which is just odd. But anyways, kind of on to a more important topic. That was a little bit more random than I had hoped, but I wanted to talk about how the channel's going and just kind of my ideas for 2017. This isn't really going anywhere in particular. I just, you know, just wanted to kind of talk about it. So leave me alone. No, I'm just kidding. All right. So as you guys know, we are sitting at about 12,000 subscribers at the moment, which is insane. I never would have hoped for that at all. I just could not have ever assumed that that would happen. But anyways, we've gone into the whole thanks for that. You guys have no idea how thankful I am, but I've always talked about it, so I'm going to not get into that today. But I wanted to talk more about, you know, the series and what we plan on doing. And I really, it's kind of in the form of an ask or a question. What am I talking about? An ask? I don't know. This is more in the form of a question, and it's something I think all YouTubers ask their viewers at one point, and I always hate asking, but just because it kind of makes me look bad. I don't know. I want to know what you guys want to see. I know that sounds a lot more simple than I was making it out to be. You're probably like, that wasn't that bad. What are you talking about? Everyone asks that. I know. That the thing is a lot of people don't even listen to it, and I'm a culprit of that. Wait a minute. This is not going to work. This is not going to work at all. Wait a minute, how did I... I'm confused. This is supposed to go one block higher. I guess I'm going to build, like, bring this up a little bit more. So we'll just continue where we are, though. I am a culprit of not actually listening to the advice you guys give me on some occasions. Normally, I do, but I think all YouTubers have a habit of asking for some sort of advice when they're just in a creative block. And then when they get out of it, they just forget that they asked in the first place. And I am definitely a culprit of that. And for that, I am sorry. But I mean it this time. It's not even about right now. I'm not necessarily in a creative block. I definitely have creative genes flowing around in me. I just want to know what it is you guys would like to see, like, over the course of this year. You know, I have some cool series plans and some hopes, of course, about things that might happen. You know, there's plenty of things that I aspire for 2017. One of those is being further into the YouTube career. But, yeah, I don't know. So I just... What is wrong with this? This is not right. Something is supposed to be here. I want to say this is supposed to be more on the, like, top of a block. But it's not going to be able to do that because it's on the, well, top half. It's on the top of the block. It's supposed to be sitting directly on a block. I feel like I'm, like, one half slab off. I mean, this will work, but, I mean, this works. Yeah. I'll just try and blend this in somehow. But anyways, let's go ahead and do that. But yeah, I don't really know where I'm going with that. It's something that I wanted to talk about with you guys. It's just kind of like, where do you want the channel to go? Well, I guess that's my job. What do you want to see, you know? What do you currently enjoy? And if this is your favorite series, why is it your favorite? You know where I'm going. You get it. I'm just going to steal this coal. I don't know where my torches went, and I also have no idea where my coal is. Oh, wait. No, it's in the storage house, the old storage house. You know, I could totally make that a house, but I've already built this, so we may as well keep it. Yeah, I still have a bed in here. I was about to say, I don't even think I have a bed in here anymore. Okay, yeah, my coal is here. Let's go ahead and grab that and just replenish myself on some torches. I don't know why we don't have any. I guess I could have thrown them out. Oh, wow. That adds a lot to it already. Man, that looks so cool. We can get the whole feel for it, too. Let's walk around the corner. Oh, what a nice tree. What a nice bigger tree. Ooh, another tree. Ooh, something's off in the distance. Oh, however will I get over there? Oh, what a nice lovely bridge. What a nice lovely pair of squids. These can be yours for $49.90. I'm just kidding. Yeah, the bridge looks great, I think. I might kind of adjust the shape eventually, but for now, this is a good starter. So let's go ahead and kind of mishmash that. I mean, this word, what? I don't know. I don't even know what I'm saying. I can't talk. I said that made no sense, but it came out that made no words. I've been recording all day today, and it's pretty hot in my apartment right now, so you may want to be worried about me. Nah, I'm just kidding. Yeah, I think I just talk a little too fast, and sometimes I need to calm down a little bit, I think. But yes, I'm gonna go ahead and just continue. What am I trying to say? Mishmash? I don't know. That makes no sense. You guys know what I'm saying. I am such a pro at commentary. I'm surprised you guys even watch me at this point because, you know, I'll be talking. I'm like that one reporter who was trying to say something and she ended up saying something like baloney or something, but it came out really weird and it looked kind of like she was having some sort of meltdown. That's what I imagine I just sounded like. Yeah, all right, so this is looking pretty cool. I kind of want to add on some fences, which is why I have them in my bag of building, because I was going to use them. I planned for it. Haha. I wanted to do this. I just feel like that adds a lot to the design. I'm not going to put torches on it like I should. I'll probably regret that later when I'm walking across and a creeper's on there. But for now, I'm perfectly fine with that. And now, as the sun goes down, we're just going to place some birch leaves around the pillars in hopes that it kind of ties it all together well and all that kind of stuff. Nothing crazy, just a small amount of stuff. I just feel like these leaves have kind of incorporated themselves very much into our build, and it would be good to just have them. I just feel like they wrap things in together. So if this is meant to look overgrown, it's definitely going to look overgrown. Oh yeah, that looks very nice. And then once we have a pathway going through here and trees and it looks all nice and cool. Dude, something is going on over here. You guys can see the frame rate. It's going good now, but something. It's in this spot. Maybe something underground. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think it is. Because it wasn't doing that earlier today. I don't know. But anyways, yeah, it's looking really cool. And it's going to look awesome once this area is all done. And then we have this bridge that we're about to make. It's going to be so cool. and let me know what you think of that. Very simple little Brits design. Ooh, and we can go right under it. How elegant. All right, let's take our foliage here, our birch leaves and our lily pads, and go ahead and create sort of like a hopping bridge, if that makes sense. Just something to where we can get over there without directly looking like it obstructs any views. This is a good way to get a bridge when you don't really want to make it look too bridgy. Quote that. That's my new quote for the year. Now, like, as you can see, we have a bridge here. If we had another bridge here, it would just look too, like, built. I don't know. I don't know what the word would be, but imagine boats coming through here. That just would not be good for the boats, especially here. So I'm not going to add a heavy bridge. We're going to do like a light bridge out of leaves. So the idea is that you basically want to get lily pads and not do that, but do that and just go kind of around them. This is going to be a lot harder than I thought it'd be. Let's try and get it going a little bit more. Just place some basic lily pads and then kind of like splash the leaves around. And I guess what we can do is just go all the way across with the leaves and then just break them. That might be the easiest thing. But one general thing I always do with it is do one on each side of it at least, just so it looks supported. Because the idea is that this is just where the current has pushed a whole bunch of marshy type things. And I think that once it's done, it'll look pretty good. And don't be afraid to have some that are just on the edge. That's fine. Okay, we're gonna do that. Kind of bring it more together in hopes that it all looks good once it's done. Oh, I'm drowning, help. Help, there we go. Okay. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. Don't worry. It looks bad. Don't worry. We're gonna fix that. Some of it I'd like for it to just be floating. Just kind of like, you know, making it look falling apart. Just something that we can at least use to jump around on. I know I just took like half of it away. But yeah, it's already starting to look a little bit better. And if we go get some like oak leaves, I think it'll look really good. These are birch leaves, so that is going to add a little bit more green if we add oak. And I just slammed into the wall, which is always fun. Let's just zoom by. I am almost dead. Let's eat and hope that that doesn't happen again. That was a little dangerous, and I hope that that's not an issue in the future. Okay, we've got a little bit, at least enough for now. Let's safely fly back over there without dying. Go under it. That was cool. I'm very professional at elytra flight. I don't know if you could tell. Oh, go squid! Go squid! Always good when they break dance. Okay, yeah, that's going to look a little odd, but that'll add at least a little bit more texture to it, I think, which is always good, in my opinion. I'd like to add one. Oh, this is going to be hard. Let's just do that. One there. Maybe that would work, actually. You know what? I'm just going to get to placing, and I will see you guys once it's all complete. Have you ever wondered whether there's a monster under this bed or not? My bets are on it. There's a monster under there, I'm telling you. I just heard some weird noises in there. There's another bed. Probably another monster under there too. So guys, we're gonna play a little bit of a role-playing type thing for a moment, just to get some feeling for the atmosphere. So let's say that we are in this cabin, you know, maybe this outhouse, because it's smaller than that by so much that this could be its own outhouse. So maybe we're over here and we're like, huh, you know what? I've always wondered what's being built over there. Let's go see what our neighbors, our rich neighbors, are doing. Maybe they can help me expand my own house. So let's see. It looks like they've actually created a bit of a pathway to get over there. Maybe we can find our way over there. Ooh. I'm not sure how I didn't notice they built this pathway beside my own apartment. That's not an apartment. I don't know what kind of apartment would be a cabin. Ooh, look at that, a little bridge. And I can see it over there. It looks very interesting. Let's continue making our way over Lag Bridge here. Ooh, wasn't that laggy, actually? Oh, what a better view. Hint, hint. Atmospheric points. LOL. No, seriously, though, guys, that is like one of the coolest looking spots ever. Is when you're following through here and there's a recycling bin and the monster. But when you're following through here and you look at that, you see like the tip, and then you focus on crossing the bridge, and by the time you've crossed the bridge and turn, you get a huge like difference in the view. I love that. That forced perspective is awesome. And I've just noticed that it gets really laggy on that spot. I'm a detective this episode, guys. You guys know I've been nonstop mentioning the lag. Something's up with that spot over there, and I'm gonna figure it out. It could be the water, though, or maybe these horrible breakdancing squids. But yeah, all right, so here's the bridge that we just finished working on. I think it looks pretty good. Very subtle and very clean, and it kind of matches this whole thing. This is supposed to be the entrance, and then this is like a second-hand way to get there. If you want to just go the back way, you can. But this is where you're supposed to go, and eventually that's going to be done. But little pro tip before we continue on with the final part of the episode. Whenever you're doing something like this, don't just put leaves on the top layer of the water. I found that if you actually like lower some of the leaves down into the water, it looks a lot better and kind of looks more like a collected moss than anything. Like some of it has, you know, gotten stuck while flowing through the current. I think that looks really cool. So let's glide our way down here very safely. I don't want to die here. It's been a while since I've come in contact with mobs. Hopefully they're not too freaked out by my wonderful pirate's hat. As you guys can see, I would be pretty freaked out. All right, so let's just try and parkour our way down here and break our ankles a little bit. And I should probably go ahead and equip our light. Let's kind of explore for a moment and just try and collect as much of it as we can. I don't want to run into a wall just like that. I don't want to run into a spider trap. That would be pretty horrendous. What is that? Did I say horrendous? I think that's the word. Oh, I thought that was a mob spawner. And another wall. This is not what we wanted, but this will work. Let's go ahead and just kind of continue onwards. Yeah, oh, what a trap. That was the trap if I've ever seen one. I really don't want to run into a spider spawner just because I do not think I am prepared for that. Realistically, let's be honest. It's been a while since I've done any form of PvP, so I think it would be best if we just stuck away from it. But as you guys can see, I'm collecting cobwebs like it's nobody's business. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I like to see. We're doing it. We're collecting it. And I think next episode you're going to come back to a fully functional, awesome... you know what? I need some iron. I'm a little poor. Let's grab the iron. But yeah, you're going to come back to a fully functional, awesome furnace. So that'll be cool. And I'm curious because... Oh, crap. Okay. Nope. Oh, that's not as bad as I thought, though. Yeah, this is a better spawner than I originally mentioned. So I was actually thinking the cave spawners. This is more than perfect. I'm actually happy with this. I'm going to have to come back for this loot, though. Well, you know what? Why not? Let's go ahead and grab it. We can grab it. God knows I'll never come back for it. Man, I am the best Minecraft survivalist ever. Look at all this loot I just got. You back, zombie. Look, you know what? I was a little scared about what was down here. But not anymore. I realize now my sword is extremely powerful, so I'm not even worried about it. Is this another ravine? Oh, wow. Oh, that freaked me out. I was like, what's going on up there? Ooh, a chest. I forgot about these things. Oh, good gosh. That's a lot of loot. That's awesome. But, yeah, I think that's enough for now. I think we're good. We've got about all the cobwebs we need. Maybe next episode we can come back here and explore just a little bit more. I think that would be pretty cool. But guys, I think that's going to do it for today. I hope you did enjoy. If you did, make sure to leave a thumbs up. And we're going to go ahead and get into the comment question of the day here in a second. I've just got to get to safety. So let's run on out through here and go back up to the mainland in hopes of not dying and getting trapped down here. Luckily, the fireworks are a thing. So let's just zoom on through. And it should be almost nighttime. It looks like we're perfectly getting out of there. Perfect timing. Fly on past the laggy bridge. And you know what? Let's just go ahead and end the episode there. I think that'll be really cool with a nice view of it. But anyways, guys, I hope you did enjoy. Let's go ahead and do the comment question of the day. I almost forgot. I always seem to forget. The comment question of the day is, what is your favorite thing to build in Minecraft and why? Do you enjoy building houses? Do you enjoy building modern houses? Do you enjoy building cars? Do you enjoy redstone? Let me know and go into detail about why you enjoy it. I just want to know how I can best reach all of you in these videos and make this a better, you know, more entertaining video for everybody. But anyways, that is the comment question of the day. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for joining along. I am so sorry for the lack of Minecraft videos lately, especially with this Let's Play. It's been very hard for me to stay on top of everything, but I'm doing it. I'm trying to get back adjusted to it, and it's working so far. So hopefully we'll have some more progress to the cabin soon. I know next episode we're definitely going to work on it a little bit more, but I'm definitely going to get production going so it'll hurry up and finish because I want to kind of move on soon. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, make sure to leave a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to the channel. If you do enjoy Minecraft, you'll be notified of when I upload and when I live stream. Anyways, guys, my name has been System Z. You guys have been awesome. Thanks for watching.